Good afternoon. Welcome to expert lecture series. Myself Dr. M.S. Dash, Associate Professor, Department of Electrical Engineering, Technocrats TIT Group of Institution, Bhopal. Today, in this expert lecture series, we will discuss about different standards and practices for transformer selection and transportation. There are so many standards available worldwide. We choose any of the standards and we follow, whether we are a buyer, a supplier, or a manufacturer. So in this lecture, first we will look into different parts of the transformer. We look into the picture, there are main parts. There are three limb core, low voltage winding, high voltage winding, tap winding, tap leads, low voltage bushings, high voltage bushings, clamping frame, on load tap changer, motor drive mechanism, tank, conservator, and radiators. Now coming to the selection part, there are so many parts that we have to take care of. So many selection features. First one is rating, second one is tap, third is connection symbol, fourth is impedance, fifth is termination arrangement, sixth cooling, seventh fittings and accessories. We have to select the transformer taking consideration in all the seven items. First, selection criteria for distribution transformer. Rating. The no load secondary voltage should be 433 volts for transformers to be used in 415 volt system. For parallel operations, the voltage ratio should be selected in accordance with the standards that is being used for the parallel operation. Taps. The transformers are normally provided with off circuit taps on high voltage side. The standard range for off circuit taps provided for high voltage side is plus minus 2.5% and plus minus 5%. When we come to on load tap changers, the taps may be in the step of 1.25% in 16 steps. This is the standard that we have to normally follow for a selection purpose. Next comes the connection. Transformers should be preferably connected in delta star. Exact connection symbol DYN11 or DYN1. That is to be specified depending upon our requirements. Generally, this type of transformer comes under 1.6 MVA. Now comes impedance. Selection of impedance for the transformer depends upon the standard rating of the switchgear on the secondary side, first one. Second one is associated voltage drop. The percentage impedance, that is very much important factor for the parallel operation of the transformer. That should be taken care of. Next, termination arrangement. Depending on the method of installation, high voltage and low voltage terminals may be bare outdoor bushing, cable box or bus trunking. Whether compound filled cable boxes are used, it is preferable to specify disconnecting chamber between transformer terminals and cable box to facilitate disconnection of transformer terminals without disturbing the cable connections. Now, come to the part of cooling. Transformers covered in this group, as because they are less than 1.5 MVA, they are generally ONAN, oil natural, AN, air natural, or ANAN, air natural and air natural cool. Fitting and accessories. This is the last option, this is the last portion. Explosion vent should be specified for 11 kV oil filled transformers above 400 kVA rating and all 33 kV transformers. Explosion vent should be there. When radiators are required to be detached for the purpose of transportation, isolating valves, that should be specified. Alarm and trip contacts for the oil temperature indicator OTI and winding temperature indicator WTI and gas actuated relay may be specified when monitoring and control transformer. This is all about distribution transformer selection. Now we will discuss about selection criteria for power transformers. Ready. The secondary no load voltage should be specified 5% more than the nominal voltage to compensate transformer regulation part. Taps. On load tap changers on high voltage side that should be specified. Off circuit taps when specified that should be in the range plus minus 2.5% and plus minus 5% provided on high voltage side. In case of OLTC, on load tap changer, the total number of taps should be 16 in steps of 1.25%. The distribution on positive or negative taps is decided to suit the system conditions. Connection. The preferred connections up to 66 kV high voltage side rating are delta star, DYN and star star, YN, YN. For higher voltage connections, star star, YN, YN or star delta, YND may be preferred. For transformers of rating up to 50 MVA, requirements are 3-limb construction, no stabilizing winding, and if tertiary winding is there, that is for auxiliary loads. Next come to the point impedance. Transformer impedance is decided taking into consideration voltage drop and secondary fault level. Percentage impedance should be selected in accordance with the standards for parallel operation. Next, termination arrangement. Depending upon the method of installation, the secondary terminals may be bare bushing, cable boxes or bus trunking. Bushing of transformer, this is the main part of transformer, and here transformers are above 1.6 MVA. So up to 33 kV, porcelain bushings are preferred, and 66 kV or above, that is oil filled condenser type bushing, that should be specified. For installation in polluted atmosphere, the bushing should be specified with creepage distances. Next, cooling. The type of cooling may be ONAN, oil natural, air natural, ONN or ONF, oil natural, air force, ONN or ONF or OFF, oil force, air force. Up to 10 MVA and 66 kV, cooling type preferred is ONAN. From 12.5 MVA to 40 MVA and up to 132 kV, the cooling type preferred is ONAN or ONAF. From 50 MVA to 100 MVA and up to 220 kV, 220 kV, the cooling type may be ONAN or ONAF or OFAN or OFAF. In the last part is oil force and air force. Fitting and accessories. First, skids and cooling locks. Second, magnetic oil level gauge with low level alarm contact. Roller, if flange rollers are used. Rail bars should be specified. Winding temperature indicator with electrical contacts for alarm or trip and controlling fans and pumps. Gas and oil actuated relay with alarm and trip contacts. For OLTC tank, a separate relay or other suitable protective device may be specified. Next point is explosion vent. That is very important point. For every transformer, it should be there to protect it from explosion. Accessories for cooling arrangement. Oil temperature indicator with alarm and trip contacts. Two sampling valves at the top and bottom of the main tank. These are all accessories and fittings. used in power transformer situation. Next come general consideration. Actually, there are so many considerations. We will discuss only general consideration and design consideration. We have to follow each and every point of time these considerations. First one is information under the heading general consideration. Information pertaining to the installation, operation and maintenance should be collected before ordering to suit the site conditions. That include any special building features, lifting beam, oil sumps, cable trenches, foundation details and ventilation arrangements. Details of the electric supply available, limiting the rating of the equipments should be ascertained from the supply authority, that include abnormal overvoltage and their duration as well variation in frequency. Both the overvoltage and variation frequencies are very important term that should be specified before ordering any equipment. Interchangeability, where a number of similar rated units are used, arrangements should be made for the interchangeability as regards to the electrical characteristics, parallel operation, fixed arrangement, space of wire, position of cable boxes or terminals, direction, gauge roller, etc. Where cable and boxes form part of the transformer, they may be of the detachable type. Compliance with electricity rules and regulations. This is the utmost requirement for any standard procedures. All electrical installations shall comply with Electricity Act and electricity rules. Any other regulations, Factories Act, Fire Insurance Act. The electrical installation shall be carried out only by authorized completed persons. No other persons are allowed to touch any electrical apparatus. Earth. All connections to the earth should be made in accordance with the practice that is meant for earth. Isolation. A circuit breaker or a link switch of requisite breaking capacity shall be installed on both sides of the transformer. This is mandatory. We have to put circuit breakers in the both sides of the transformer so as to carry and break the current of all phases. All the isolating devices shall be placed in an accessible positions. Next point is provision for draining. Transformers where the oil capacity exceeds 2000 liter shall be provided with oil soak pit. Oil soak pit may be of RCC tanks. In the figure you can see that there is a soak pit that is outside the transformer room. That should be slope provided for this so that oil will automatically come to the soak pit. For indoor transformers, oil soak pit may be provided just under the transformer or that should be outside. If two or more transformers are installed side by side, they shall be separated by fire separation wall. This is mandatory. Two transformers will be separated by fire separation walls. The capacity of the oil soak pit shall be such that it should soak all entire oil content of the transformer. Next part is design consideration. This is very important part. Special requirements may have to be compiled with the special features might have to be built into the system during design stage of the transformer. Many things that come into the design stage because of the requirement for the site conditions, because of the requirement in the installation and maintenance. First one is the operating temperature. The construction, installation, operation and maintenance of all the apparatus service such that operating temperature of the components do not exceed the safe figures that is laid down in the specifications. Protection of circuits and apparatus. All apparatus and associated cable wire should be protected at the origin of the circuit against the effect of electrical faults by a suitable device, generally circuit breaker. Neutral connections. This is very important part, neutral connection. The connection between the neutral of the transformer and the earth depends upon, first of all, transformer cost. Second, method of protection of transformer. Third thing, electrical system requirements concerning interface with the telephone line. Next, terminations. When cables are terminated adjacent to the transformer and a bare connection is made from the cable terminals to the transformer bushing, the cable terminal should be at a sufficiently high elevation so that it cannot be accessible. Next, isolation of equipment. Means should be provided for the complete isolation of the transformer. This is very important aspect for the safety point of view. Its control circuit, pilot and interlocking circuit from the supplier. If it is not practicable to carry out complete isolation with a single device, clear and concise instructions should be affixed to the apparatus in a permanent manner, setting out procedures to be adopted to secure complete isolation. For the system, complete isolation is must. So if a single device cannot isolate completely, then we have to put the procedures all round that how to isolate the complete system. In an inflammable atmosphere, isolation should be placed in an enclosure independent of the apparatus. First one, second one is shall be mounted in a flame-proof enclosure. This isolating means should be provided, have an independent access cover. Surge protection. The protection of the transformer from the surges of atmosphere or any other origin shall be examined carefully for lightning arresters. That should be in accordance with the standards meant for lightning arrester. And earthing of lightning arrester, that should again follow the standards for earthing. Next part comes transportation. This is a very vital part because transformer after manufacturing that should come to the site for detection purpose. The engineer should obtain well in advance all the relevant information about the overall dimensions, weight for transport, dimensions of transport, installation, etc. Often it is necessary to check up with rail and road authorities for the purpose of transporting. This may involve procurement of transshipment facilities, special wagon or trailer, checking up of capacity of the bridges, railway loading, etc. It is also desirable to check with insurer for the purpose of transient insurance. Transient insurance is must for heavy transportation. Now comes packing and dispatch. According to the transportation facility available, transformers are transported either by rail, road or sea. Transformers after processing and testing are dispatched from the factory either, first one is dry and completely filled with oil, second one is with oil covering ore and oil, balance space filled with dry air or inert gas, third one completely filled with dry air or inert gas at a small positive pressure. We have to follow any one of them. In case of large transformers, Some of the accessories are detached separately. Second one, in case a tank is filled with oil, sufficient space is left above the oil to take care of the expansion. This space is filled with generally inert gases with positive pressure or dry air under atmospheric pressure. External gas cylinders may also be provided to make up the gas leakage during transit for the transformers having rating 50 MVA and above. This is must. External gas cylinders are generally provided. All external fittings such as bushings, conservators, Bockel's relay, dehydrating grader, explosion vent, radiators, rollers, etc., which are liable to damage during transit, shall be removed and packed separately. When any internal parts like tap changers or insulating items are removed from for the transportation purpose, they should be detached, they should be dispatched in tanks filled with oil or inert gas, or suitable measures are taken so that they do not absorb moisture. Moisture absorption is a very important factor in the transportation phase of a transformer. All fragile parts such as temperature indicator, oil level gauge, bushings, etc. shall be carefully packed to avoid breakage in transit. Next, come to the point, rail transport. A majority of the transformers are transported by rail due to the consideration in weight as well as dimensions and economy. Special wagons are employed for heavy weight and dimensions. Detached parts are packed, crated, and normally dispatched along with the main body of the unit. Loading. Most of the transformer manufacturers have their own railway siding, and transformers are loaded at their works using their own crane. Where separate sliding contacts are not available, road tractor trailers are used from the works to loading railway stations, where mobile cranes and railway cranes are used for the loading of the units onto the water. Jacks and pull lifts, chain pulley blocks of the adequate capacity are used to slide the transformer over a pair of rails placed on the sleeper platform where cranes are not available. From the platform, the transformer is slid onto the water. In the picture you can see how rail transport is being done. Lifting and jacking. Transformers should be lifted by lugs and shackles provided for the purpose, and simultaneous use of locks and shackles is must in order to avoid any unbalance in lifting. This is the standard. It is advisable to use spreader between slings so that lift on the hook is in the vertical direction. The sling angle should not exceed 60 degrees. This is a standard that everybody has to follow. Safe loads of wear rope and the multiplying factor to be used corresponding to the lifting angles. Safe load for the wear rope is very important factor. Many accidents happen because of this safe loading. Lashing. A transformer is lashed on all four sides by wear ropes or chain of adequate size and are tightened using turn buckles with loading locking facility. After the movement of the wagon for a short distance, the tightness of the lashing is to be checked. Next, road transport. Generally, road transport is preferred where first one, smaller units are transported. Second, rail links are not available. Third, well-developed road system exists. Multi-axle tractor driven low platform trailer are generally used for the road transportation. Route survey. This is very important part in the road transportation. We have to survey the route before any transportation over road. The road system is examined in detail. First point, width of the road that should normally not less than 5 meters. Bridges and culverts. We have sufficient strength to take the moving road. For this, consultation with highway authorities or department is necessary. Sharp bend and gradients, steep gradients up or down, and sharp bends with respect to the maneuverability of the tractor trailer is surveyed. Road worthiness and the road bearing capacity of the road is a very important factor. The route like sandy stretches, waterlogged areas, crowded localities like market places, schools and other public places that should be located. To test the feasibilities of the route, a rehearsal drive of the tractor trailer unit is performed many places. Next part is strengthening the route. Bridges and culverts which require strengthening are strengthened by adopting suitable measures like coping up using timber and steel, but that is in consultation with highway authorities. In some cases, an alternate route by passing such bridges and culverts may be cheaper than coping up. Next point is movement. A pilot vehicle with all tools and tackles like jets, sleeper, chakkar plates, cover, etc. and sufficient trained staff should be run in front of the vehicle. Everybody has to follow this standard for road transportation. Red flags and danger lamps should be exhibited at prominent places to warn traffic. Many accidents do occur because of negligence of this danger lamp as well as red flag. In branches of avenue, trees that are likely to fall, the equipment should be cleared while the load is moved. Electric utility power lines likely to foul should be switched off and lifted temporarily, or it may be dismantled. In the case of night halt or stoppage on the loaded trailer, for the fairly long duration, the trailer should be supported either by sleepers or providing supporting jacks so that releasing the loads of the tires. Danger lights should be displayed in front of the rear of the vehicle. Next part is speed. For the normal running, it is desirable not to run the vehicle over 15 to 20 km per hour with no load and 10 to 15 km with load on good surface roads. But in case of bad roads, it is desirable to run the vehicle at much lower speed. Next, brakes. While running over any bridge or culverts, the vehicle should be run only at a very slow speed. Speed should be brought down and vehicle is allowed to proceed over the bridge without creating any impact which is caused by applying brakes when running at high speeds. Transportation should be avoided during heavy rain and foggy weather. In the picture you can see how road transport and water transport is done. Next, water transport. Barges are used for inland navigation routes. Anti-corrosive paint, silica gel packings, sealing using polythene covers are generally used for prevention of rusting of parts and increase of moisture in water transport. ingress of moisture is definitely there in the system. Packages should not be left on the racks for more than 2 weeks. Loading. Special floating cranes or cranes of ships are used for loading the packages from the warehouse to ship or barges. In the case of barges, special care is required to prevent overturning at the time of loading. Decks of the ships are not generally used for the transportation purpose. Next, unloading at site. In case where substations are having adequate crane facility, transformers is unloaded by crane or mobile cranes. Where no crane facilities is available, first a trench is dug to a depth equal to the height of the trailer platform and the transformer is slipped to the position. If it is not possible, the transformer is unloaded on a sleeper platform. Wrenches are to be used for putting the transformer in position. Next, inspection. It is recommended that immediately on arrival, the transformer should be unpacked and examined for any sign of damage during transit. Attention is being made to the tank sides or pulling tubes if it's dented, fittings damaged, oil side glass broken, bushings cracked or broken, bolt loose during vibration in transit, oil leakage particularly along the welds or reduction in the pressure of the gases, damage to auxiliaries. If it is suspected that transformer has sufficient material damage, suitable action is taken. There are 3 type of damages. First one is serious damage. Serious damage should be reported to the manufacturer. It is advisable to wait till the representative of both manufacturer as well transporter are present before lifting the poles and coils of the tank for further inspection. Slight damage. Damage which does not appear to be serious but which indicates heavy knock should be treated with caution. The core of the transformer should be lifted from the tank in the presence of a representative of both the manufacturer as well transporter and examined for any damage. If third one is no damage, if there are no external damage, then it is advisable to leave the transformer in the tank without making any attempt even to look into it. Moisture. Absorption of moisture by the windings are generally checked by the presence of rust and condensation anywhere, either within or outside the tank. Secondly, the pink color of the silica gel trailer fitted for transport. If the transformer is supplied filled with nitrogen or any other inert gases, its pressure should be checked in accordance with the temperature pressure chart. At the time of receipt, oil samples from the top of the conservator and the bottom of the transformer should be drawn and tested for moisture and for dielectric strength. Insulation resistance are also measured for the transformer. If examination indicates the ingress of moisture, then the transformer shall be dried under vacuum, filled with dry nitrogen or oil, and then stored. The oil contained in the transformer on receipt shall also be filtered before storing. This is a very important point. Care shall be taken to ensure that the gaskets are tight. Generally, leaks are through gasket. Next part is storage. Indoor type transformer should be stored under cover. Preferably be filled with oil to reduce the possible condensation of moisture and breather pipe that should be plugged in. Transformers which are to be kept in storage for long periods. First one, it should preferably be drained of oil. Second, the tank should be filled with dry nitrogen under slight pressure. If it is necessary to store them outdoors, this should be covered to prevent moisture and foreign materials entering into the tank. To store partially or completely disassembled transformer, first one, the core and the coils should be immersed in dry oil, stored in a dry room having uniform temperature. These are the standards that we have to follow during storage. If the unit is stored outdoors without oil, moisture may condense in the tank. To avoid this, it should be filled with nitrogen or any other inert gases. This is all about transformer selection and transportation. Every manufacturer, supplier and buyer all follow these rules and regulations. Thank you.